Roxy. Just kidding, I'm still Katie, I promise, but I have my Roxy makeup on because today I'm going to be showing you guys how I transform into Roxy and how I get ready for my short program competition, and I'm super, super excited to show you guys my makeup look, and I hope you're excited too. If you have not seen my short program, a Roxy routine yet, I will link it right up there or down below for you guys on mobile devices, so go check that out. If you like these kinds of videos, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Let's try to get to 200 thumbs up. I think we can do it. There's 3,000 of you guys, which is crazy. So just keep giving me your thumbs and we're gonna try to make it to 200. I think we can do it. I believe in my little ice skates. Click that thumbs up. Anyway, if you wanna see how to get this Roxy makeup look, then keep on watching. Hello, welcome to Naked Face Katie. I'm really sorry you have to see this, but please bear with me. There'll be makeup on my face soon. So I just put a headband on because I have a lot of hair, and it's really annoying when your hair gets in your makeup, and not good for competition day. We don't need any more stress, so put a headband on. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to be starting out with is a moisturizer. This is the Olay Active Hydrating Moisturizer. I put a little on my hands. Oh gosh, it's been a little on my neck, so we're not too crazy lotioned. I always apply moisturizer because my skin is very combination, so it's not oily, but it's not dry. It depends on the season, so I always apply moisturizer because if I don't, my skin will dry up. And if I do, it will be calm and healthy, and my makeup won't sit weird because I have dry skin, so always apply moisturizer. So I ran out of my primer that I usually use for competition. It's an Hourglass primer, and yeah, I don't have it anymore, but I usually apply a primer, and I totally recommend applying a primer before a competition because we know we cry about happiness and how well we did. So the foundation I'm going to be using today is the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, and I only use this on special occasions like competitions. Depends on the day. Whatever I'm doing, I probably won't use this. For everyday wear, I usually use this BB cream, but for special occasions, I use my Too Faced Born This Way because it was expensive, but it's so pretty. So I'm just going to apply this to the back of my hand. It has a pump, which I'm in love with. I applied 3 pumps. I just grabbed a little on my beauty blender, and this is actually really light for me. I got the lightest shade for some reason because I was really pale. We will bronze it up, don't worry. I'm gonna look really pale for a little while, but you know, that's okay. Alrighty, now we are all pretty much blended in. I look very pale. Make sure I blend it in with my neck because our pictures would not look good if it's not on our neck, and I do not have any concealer, so I'm just gonna apply one more pump of the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, and I'm just going to take it with my finger and apply it under my eyes, kind of act like a concealer, and maybe put it on some other areas. I know people do not recommend this, but I don't have any concealer. All right, so just making sure it's blended down my neck like I did before, and I think we're done with foundation. So on competition day, we do not want our under eyes to crease, so let's apply some powder under our eyes first because we don't want that to crease right now. I just take a little brush and I just pack that powder on so we don't crease anytime soon. I'm also applying that in my T-zone area and anywhere else that I get oily. And by the way, I'm using the Stay Matte by Rimmel powder for this. I forgot to tell you guys. I'm very, very sorry, but yeah. Now I'm going in with a big fluffy brush to make sure I got all the areas of my face, but that small little brush was just to get all those little areas. Now we got our base done and I'm ready for some bronzer because I look really pale right now. I usually use 2 different kinds of bronzer. I use one that's more of a bronzer and one's more of a contour. And right now I'm taking the Too Faced Chocolate Bar Soleil. I think that's what it's called. Chocolate Bronzer Soleil something or other. This is in the medium shade. I'm really not sure what it's called. There's like milk chocolate dark chocolate something something, but yeah, this is the second shade. So I'm just taking this big fluffy brush and just bronzing up my face. And we're gonna go in with another bronzer and kind of contour a little bit. I think my face is all bronzed up, and now I'm gonna go in with my Hoola Bronzer by Benefit. I'm using the little brush that came with it because I think it's great for getting those cheekbones, and I really like it. So let's try our best not to screw this up now. So I'm just getting right under the cheekbone. So just applying some to my forehead. Now that we're all chiseled and good to go, I'm going to be applying blush, and I'm actually using a blush from an eyeshadow palette. This is the Swamp Queen Graveyard Girl palette. She is a YouTuber, and I think this palette is amazing. It's with Tarte, and I love Tarte. I love the smell of these eyeshadows. I was so excited to get it, but actually the first one I got was broken. It came in the mail broken, and I had to email Sephora, and I was just like so upset. I just got home from competition that day, and I was like, what? It's broken. I was waiting all weekend to get this palette and it was broken. But I got a new one, so we're all good. And I'm taking a Does This Thing Really Work in this palette, and I'm just dusting that on my cheeks. I'm not a huge blush person. I've said that a lot in my videos. But I need a little pop of color on my cheeks. And I really, really like this color. So now we're gonna move on to eyeballs. So again, we're using the Graveyard Girl palette. There are 9 shades in here that I think are absolutely beautiful. They blend so nicely, and my brothers are screaming outside. Thank you. So I'm going in with the colors Natural Peaches and Big Baby. And Natural Peaches is like a peachy color, and Big Baby is like a creamish color. So I'm gonna be applying that in my crease. This is my transition shade. I just apply this first. So now that I'm done building up my crease color, I'm gonna be going in with Man Cat on my outer corner, which is like a deep purple, and I think it's beautiful. So I really like this color for Roxy. It works really well. I'm just applying this to my outer corner, and I'm just kind of like blending it in one place. Now I'm gonna kind of dust off the excess on my hand and use the same brush and kind of blend that into my crease just to make sure there's no harsh lines. I'm a crazy blender. I'm gonna go back in with Natural Peaches and Big Baby mixed together, and I'm just gonna keep blending. Now that we are done with our crease and outer V, I'm gonna go in for the lid. I'm using a L'Oreal Infallible Shadow in Amber Rush. I really like this color for Roxy. It totally works, and I'm just gonna take a little bit on my finger and just apply that to the lid. I'm gonna be going back in with this shadow and just applying it on my inner under eye. That's what you want to call it. Another great thing about these shadows is you don't need a brush. All you need is your finger, and I really like these. They're very creamy, and the formula is awesome. They're long wearing, so that's another bonus. So now I'm taking a flat brush from Tarte and applying some Man Cat just under my eyes and smoking that out. And that's it for my eyeshadow. Now moving on to mascara. I blow dry my eyelash curler to make my lashes stay all day. And for competition, it's very important for your makeup to stay all day, so I'm just gonna be blow drying this now. Again, guys, like I said in my last makeup tutorial, touch this with your hand if you do this trick. And make sure it's not too hot that you're gonna burn your eyelashes off or hurt yourself. So now I'm gonna be applying my Maybelline Rocket Volume Mascara in Waterproof. Waterproof mascara, like I've said before, makes my lashes stay curled all day. It holds them together, and it's great for competition just in case you cry out of happiness of how well you did. So sorry I didn't film the mascara portion of this. It's just really hard to get a good angle. And this eye turned out really good, and this eye turned out like bleh. So that's just what we're working with today. So now for eyebrows, I really don't do too much with my eyebrows because I have too much eyebrow as it is, but I'm just using this little eyebrow gadget spoolie, I think they call them, and just combing that through my eyebrows just to get them in place. And I should apply a brow gel, but I don't have one. I've just never been a brow person. I'm just not good at that stuff. So guys, my camera stopped recording and it didn't tell me. So I put on my lipstick and I put on something else. All I did was apply my Smashbox Always On Liquid Lipstick in the color Boss. This lipstick is made by I Superwoman I. She made this with Smashbox, and I love her so much. Lily Singh, if you guys haven't watched her videos, go watch her right now. It's I Superwoman I, like I said before. And I did apply my highlight. I like applying my highlight last just in case anything falls out and it ruins my highlight. But I just applied Gator Wings from the Swamp Queen Graveyard Girl palette. I've been using the this palette the whole time. I love this palette so, so much. But yes, just look at this highlight. I'm feeling it. I'm not blind those judges. And I definitely recommend this palette from Tarte. It's awesome. It smells great. And I totally recommend the Smashbox lipsticks. Like I said a million times, I just love it. And it doesn't dry out your lips. It's awesome. It stays on all day. I just love it. So this is the finished look, but to set it all in, I'm going to be using the setting spray by NYX. It's a matte finish setting spray, and I'm just going to shake that up and spray it all over my face. We're going to spray a lot so we make sure our makeup stays all competition day, so let's go. I really hope you guys enjoyed that makeup tutorial, and remember to click that thumbs up, smash that button, and we're gonna try to get to 200. I'm setting a goal for the first time. I know we can do it. If you want more videos like this, then let me know in the comments down below. I would love to do these kind of videos for you guys. Or if you want more figure skating videos, I will do those for you guys. Just let me know what you want to see down below. And if you haven't already, remember to click that subscribe button and become a little ice skate and a member of our big happy iKatie family. And I love you guys so, so much. Again, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will talk to you guys next week. Have an amazing day, you amazing people. Bye bye, my little ice skates. Love you.